Chapter 3, Describing, Exploring, and Comparing Data. 3.1, Measures of Center. The key concept. The focus of this section is to obtain a value that measures the center of a data set. In particular, we present measures of center, including mean and median. Our objective here is not only to find the value of each measure of center, but also to interpret those values. Download a copy of the formulas and charts packet to use while completing homework, quizzes, and practice tests the remainder of the semester. The packet is located in Canvas Files. You'll be provided with a copy of the packet during on-campus testing, beginning with test 2 and continuing through the final exam. A measure of center is a value at the center or middle of a data set. We will study the following measures of center: mean, median, mode, and mid-range. A statistic is resistant if the presence of extreme values or outliers does not cause it to change very much. The mean, or arithmetic mean, of a set of data is the measure of center found by adding all the data values and dividing the total by the number of data values. Important properties of the mean. Sample means drawn from the same population tend to vary less than other measures of center. The mean of a data set uses every data value. A disadvantage of the mean is that just one extreme value or outlier can change the value of the mean substantially. The mean is not resistant. Some notation that we'll use that you need to familiarize yourself with. You'll see similar notation throughout the remaining sections in this content that we covered this semester. The first one is the symbol read as a sum or summation. The summation, this symbol right here, denotes the sum of a set of data values. Lowercase x is the variable usually used to represent the individual data values. Lowercase n is the number of data values in a sample. Uppercase n is the number of data values in a population. This symbol, x with a line on the top, is pronounced x bar. And it's the mean of a set of sample values. This symbol is pronounced mu, and is the mean of all values in a population. Here's the formula for the sample mean. Here's the formula for the population mean. What is the difference or differences between the two formulas? Note the use of the symbol. Here we have x bar for sample mean, lowercase x, lowercase n. Here we have mu for the population mean, still a lowercase x, but notice the capital N to denote that we have all the elements in the population and not just a sample. Example. Dataset 32, Airport Data Speeds, and Appendix B includes measures of data speeds of smartphones from 4 different carriers. Find the mean of the first 5 data speeds for Verizon. Here are the data speeds that we're going to use: 38.5, 55.6, 22.4, 14.1, and 23.1. These are all in megabits per second, or capital MBPS. To find the mean, we first write the formula, and it is a sample, so we're using x bar is equal to the summation of x divided by the number of elements in the sample. Notice that the formula is written originally, then the data values are plugged in. In the top, we're looking for the sum of all the data values, so we simply add the 5 numbers together. And the bottom number is the number of data points. In this case, it is 5. When you plug the numbers into the calculator to add them, you should end up with a sum of 153.7. And that's divided by 5, which gives you 30.74 megabits per second. Now, notice the rounding. The original data points are all to the tenths place. all of the original data points, and the answer is rounded to the hundredths place. And we've also included the unit that the number is representative of, megabits per second in this particular case. Never use the term average when referring to a measure of center. Now, I am guilty of that. I do tend to say average. Most of the time I am talking about mean. But you really have to be careful when you use the word average, because average is the measure of center. Which measure of center are you referring to? The word average is often used for mean, but sometimes used for other measures of center. The term average is not used by statisticians. The term average is not used by the statistics community or professional journals. The next measure of center is median. The median of a data set is the measure of center that is in the middle, or is the middle value when the original data values are arranged in order of increasing or decreasing magnitude. Some important properties of the median. The median does not change by large amounts when we include just a few extreme values, so the median is a resistant measure of center. The median does not directly use every data value. For example, if the largest value is changed to a much larger value, the median does not change. Calculation and notation of the median. The median of a sample is sometimes denoted by X with a little squiggly mark over the top of it, which is pronounced X tilde, or capital M, or MED. To find the median, you first sort the values, arrange them in order, and then follow one of these two procedures. If the number of data values is odd, the median is the number located in the exact middle of the sorted list. If the number of data values is even, the median is found by computing the mean of the two middle numbers in the sorted list. For example, here is a data set, that's the Verizon data set, that has an odd number of data values, and we want to find the median. The first thing we do is we sort the data values by arranging them in ascending or descending order. We chose to do ascending order. And we look for the data value that's physically in the middle. If I count, this is the first, second, third, fourth, fifth data points. The third is physically in the middle. So that's what we're looking for, is that physical middle when we look for the median. In this particular case, the median, X tilde, or tilde, is equal to 23.1 megabits per second. If we have an even number of data values, we're still looking for the physical middle, but we have a calculation to perform. So we order the data from smallest to biggest, or biggest to smallest, and then we look for the physical middle. Well, if I do the same thing I just did and I number these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, notice the middle, the physical middle, would fall in between those two numbers. Therefore, because the number of data values is an even number, the median is found by computing the mean of the two middle numbers. So I'm looking for halfway between the two middle numbers. In this particular case, the two middle numbers are 23.1 and 24.5. Finding the halfway point, or the mean between those, I add the two numbers, divide by 2, and this is the median of this set of six data values, 23.80 megabits per second. The next measure of center is the mode. The mode of a data set is the value or values that occur with the most or greatest frequency. The important properties of the mode. The mode can be found with qualitative data, and that's data that's nominal, that doesn't have order implied, or maybe has order, but it's more names of things versus numerical values. A data set that can have no mode, or one mode, or more than one mode. A data set can have one mode, more than one mode, or no mode. When two data values occur with the same greatest frequency, each one is a mode and the data set is said to be bimodal. When more than two data values occur with the same greatest frequency, each is a mode and the data set is said to be multimodal. When no data values are repeated, we say that there is no mode. Here's an example. Find the mode of these sprint data speeds in megabits per second. Notice that the circled numbers are repetitive. 0.3 is repeated 3 times. So 3 separate data values of the 7 that are presented are 0.3. Therefore, 0.3 megabits per second is the data speed that occurs most often and is the mode. Other mode examples. The data speeds in megabits per second of 0.3, 0.3, 0.6, 4.0, and 4.0 have two modes because 0.3 occurs twice in the data set and 4.0 occurs twice in the data set. We say that there are two modes. In the next example, we see the data set doesn't have any repeated data values, therefore there is no mode in that data set. And the last measure of center that we're going to calculate is called the midrange. The midrange of a data set is the measure of center that is the value midway between the maximum and minimum values in the original data set. It's found by adding the maximum data value to the minimum data value and then dividing the sum by 2, as in the following formula. Midrange is equal to the sum of the maximum and minimum data values divided by 2. Important properties of the midrange. Because the midrange uses only the maximum and minimum values, it is very sensitive to the extreme, so the midrange is not resistant. In practice, the midrange is rarely used, but it has 3 redeeming features. It's very easy to compute. The midrange helps reinforce the very important point that there are several different ways to define the center of a data set. And the value of the midrange is sometimes used incorrectly for the median, so confusion can be reduced by clearly defining the midrange along with the median. Here's an example. Find the midrange of these Verizon data speeds. The midrange is the sum of the maximum and minimum data values, in this case 55.6 and 14.1. Those are added together, divided by 2. And notice that we kept the accuracy to 2 decimal places, and that is 34.85 megabits per second for the midrange. Round-off rules for measures of center. For the mean, median, and midrange, carry 1 more decimal place than is present in the original set of values. For the mode, leave the value as is without rounding because values of the mode are the same as some of the original data values. Critical thinking. We can always calculate measures of center from a sample of numbers, but we should always think about whether it makes sense to do that. We should also think about the sampling method used to collect the data. For example, critical thinking and measures of center. See each of the following illustrating situations in which the mean and median are not meaningful statistics. Can you identify the level of measurement, nominal, ordinal, interval, or ratio for each? Letter A. Zip codes of the Gateway Arch in St. Louis, White House, Air Force Division of the Pentagon, Empire State Building, and Statue of Liberty are 63102, 20500, 20330, 10118, 10004. The zip codes don't measure or count anything. The numbers are just labels for geographic location. It would not make sense to calculate the mean and median for this. And the level of measurement is nominal. Those are names for different geographical regions. The next example is ranks of selected national universities of Harvard, Yale, Duke, Dartmouth, and Brown from the U.S. News and World Report. They are ranked at 2, 3, 7, 10, and 14, respectively. The ranks reflect an ordering, but they don't measure or count anything. Therefore, finding the mean and median for these particular ranks doesn't make any sense. And because order does, there is an indicated order that makes sense, it is at the ordinal level of measurement.